I'm here with Max Brandrett, the master art forger.
Yes.
We've just talked about 60s and when you met the cranes. So
yes, when I'd finished this smudge, as we say, and walked up the road with who I found out was Ronnie Cray's boyfriend, we went to a pub, I think it was the Duke of Lonsdale. And instead of going to the main bar, I went to a side bar. And I walked in, I thought it was quite dark. No, it wasn't. Ronnie Cray was sitting down and Reggie was at the bar. Frankie Fraser was in the corner. And as immediately I knew who they were. And I didn't freeze, I just stood there. And Ronnie stood up and he walked towards me and said, "You got the smudge then, son?" I went, "Yes." He said, I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Don't call me sir, all right? Don't call me sir." I went, "Okay." I tried not to. He said, "Show me." So I said, "Where is it?" I pulled it out of the bag and it went all quiet. And I thought, God, he doesn't like it. And he goes, "Reggie, have a look at this, Reggie. Reggie, this is bloody proper, mate. This is proper." He said, "You did this?" I went, "I did." He said, "It's mum's eyes, isn't it? It's mum's eyes, he's got it." And Reggie comes over and said, "Yeah," he said, "that's, you did that?" I went, "I did." So he said, "Have a drink." So I had a shandy and I sat, no word of a lie, Mark, I sat between Ronnie Cray that side, Reggie there, I was in the middle. And then the boy, Frankie Fraser was out on the other side. The boyfriend was standing up. And they were talking about me. And he said, "Love it." He said, "I love the smudge, son. How much are you then?" I went, and I was going, you know, and he went, Reggie says, "Give him a two." I thought, £2? No, it was £200. £200 in 1967 was like giving you 1,000.
Yeah.
And I couldn't believe it. I couldn't get out quick enough, at least, honestly. And I walked out.
And did they commission art again?
No,
from you,
I never saw
them. Was that the only time?
He invited me to Valence Road to meet his mum, but I declined the offer on that when I said I had a cold, so I couldn't go.
Yeah.
And
And did that led you to kind of produce more art, didn't it then?
Was yeah.
Because obviously,
then I became a forger.
For
yeah. And then I met the great Tom Keating, and then say no more.
Yeah.
The master art forger. He was the business. You know, I'll tell you the reason why we got away with it so long in the auction rooms. The auction rooms couldn't work out. Do you know when you get a painting that's very old, it starts to crack, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's called crackula or patina or whatever it is. So Tom found a way of making the cracks. And what it is, you're probably too young to remember woodwork at school. It was called bead glue or scotch glue, right?
Right.
And this is like a dry glue. It's like, looks like lentils. You buy a pound in that for a bit. You get a great big tub of it for that. Place it in a pot. Overnight, cold water, it goes to a jelly. Next morning, you take your old picture, right?
Yeah.
And it goes to a glue light. You brush it over, right? Take it to a heater, not a dry heater, electric heater. Keep circling it like that, and it starts to crack. You'll actually hear it cracking. And then Tom used to say, "Yeah, a bit more in the sky there, son." And so he used to do that.
Yeah.
And then you take it to the tap, you wash off the bead glue, because it's water-based. You get your Hoover out with a dust bag, you dust it all over, wipe the surface off, it's full of dirt, all the cracks are full of black. White polish on top of that, glass on top of that, old nails from the garden on top of that, in the auctions, and then go down to the auction and say, "Hello, John, would you have a look up these smudges?" That's how we used to do it.
Yeah, and there was a big market for that. I mean, is there a lot of art forgers around nowadays, or
yeah, some very good ones.
Is it becoming harder to kind of get?
Well, I don't think there's any art forgers. I think because if you're forging, you know, it's a dangerous game, as I proved it. Three stretches in Nick's is it's not a good idea, is it?
Yeah.
So I'm a legit artist doing copies. I'm a copyist.
Yes.
I used to be a forger. I mean, known for a forger, you know.
Yeah. And what artists do you... got Jack Vetriano here, but what other artists do you try and copy?
Coolidge, Caravaggio, the Ertes, Feinekers, Louis Waynes, you name it, I've painted it. Whatever you put in front of me, I'll copy.
Yeah, and you've now got a gallery, haven't you? So that's
important. Yeah, I've got a gallery to go to.
Yeah.
I mean, you think... 2 years ago, I was teaching on stage called a company called Entertainment Direct, where you've got lovely, beautiful, lovely old ladies in their 80s and 90s. The thing is, before he got there with his big lectures in, they used to go to sleep on me. I think, oh no. He said the first 7 rows would sleep. So they, you know.
Yeah.
But I did love teaching them, you know.
And a bit more about the art. How long would these paintings, how long do you spend on
I think about 3 or 4 days doing the Vitriani. See, the big pictures like the old masters a lot longer, you know, but I'd say paint, you know, maybe a week, 2 weeks on them. The Coolidges I really love doing. I mean, if you know his art, it's Victorian playing poker. I just love the detail in it.
Yes.
So, but, you know, I'm not keen on the Lowry's too much. I'm not keen on Picasso's. Because I'm going to be honest, I don't find them challenging enough, you know.
Yeah. And have you ever been in direct contact with some of the artists that you copy?
Only him to get his signature right. Sorry about that.
You come back to Brighton quite often, don't you? It's changed.
I love the lanes. Don't forget, I got nicked and just down the road here a few 2 years ago, especially Edward Street, you know.
These paintings here, I mean, these are just for your own.
You see, you can't put these in the gallery, Mark, because he's still around.
Yes.
So that would be copyright. But I always change it slightly, like I put a glass in there, so it's not an actual copy. It's not a bad copy, that, I must admit. If you looked at the original, that's not far off it, you know. But, I don't do this so much now, because these for a private a person who bought these, you know. But I'm happy with what I'm doing now. I love it.
Yeah, and I know there's quite a few people that do copy art, as we've said. I mean, what do you think they're as good as the work that you've produced, or?
No, I mean, you know, you've got a couple of Brighton artists that are pretty good. You know, I mean, they're excellent at what they do. We all do our different things. I don't have any problem. You know, they do their thing, I do mine. I mean, you know, there's guys doing them all over, you know, but you can't get them through the rooms anymore. You know, in my day you could, because they've got all x-rays and, you know, if you've seen that programme Fake or Fortune, right, you couldn't get one of those through on new canvas, you know. We did. Tom Keating was one of the best in the business, and I studied under him. You know, as you know, I get a Christmas card from the Ford Squad every year. Wish you were here, Max. Bless you.
It was much easier, was it, in the 60s and 70s? I mean, standard.
Oh, absolutely.
Reason. Yeah, I mean, what was some of the... there's probably quite a few fakes going around that you were involved in then that on people's walls.
Yeah, quite a few, actually.
What, are they... obviously...
Well, you don't know, do they? Yeah, I can, yeah. A couple of years ago, I went to a house and this for having dinner, and I thought, hello, it's one of mine on the wall there. You know, I can't remember. Oh, I think I did a quite nice shipping scene, you know, shipping off Dover, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And it was definitely one of mine, and it was one I did when I was with Tom Keating, because of the ageing process, and I know my pictures as well. But
that's key, isn't it, to art forgery? It's that.
Oh, yeah, I mean, old canvas, but. Yeah. You know, the auction rooms were not too clever with that bead glue. I mean, we did fool them a bit, you know.
Is it still the same process that people use now to kind of try and age the canvas?
I think you could do it. I mean, yeah, I think you could go into an auction room. I mean, in my day, Tom Keating and I used to go in as father and son, like leather jackets, polo neck jumpers, and then go to the auction rooms. I'm not going to mention which one, because I'm barred from a few. And they would go in, so, hello, sir, got a couple of smudges in the car, so do you have a look? So what we used to do, we used to put a painting there, two goodies and a lot of pot boilers, what we call pot boilers. And the auctioneer would be going with their authority, yes, nice, nice, yes. And then he'd come to the goodie and he'd go, oh, yes, that's quite interesting. And I did a lovely painting of shipping off Dover, right? And he went, oh, yes, that's interesting. I said, can you tell me about it? So he said, yeah, it's probably Norwich School. Was it painted in Norwich, sir? He went, no, it's Norwich School. You know,
plans for the future, you've got this, your work exhibited at the gallery, so it's kind of changed quite a bit now. That's in Worthing. Where can we find that?
That's in Warwick Street.
Warwick Street, okay.
In Worthing. And also, I've got a book deal. And also, the other thing is, I'm happy with what I'm doing.
Yeah.
No more forgeries, I promise, Gub.
Perfect. That's a perfect way to end it. Max, thanks for coming in today.
My pleasure.
And see you soon.
Yeah.
Cheers.